And we're back. Game two, Titan versus Vici Gaming. Exciting stuff. Very, very exciting stuff. Game one was one hell of a game. It was long. It was dramatic. It's full of back and forth. It was great. It was great. And if you're just now joining us, you missed out. You missed out. But thankfully, we've got the perfect thing for you. YouTube.com/joindota. We're going to be uploading the VOD, so you can check that out anytime you like. And I mean anytime. So, I'll be uploading that after the match. Should be up. Depends on the upload rate. But definitely this time tomorrow, maybe it'll be up. Should be, anyway. Unless something awful happens, technically. Oh. I also want to remind you guys that not only are you getting a dose of me today, this guy, but you're also getting a dose of Toby later on with the Champions League. So be sure to check that out. I may or may not join him. It's a little iffy. It's a little iffy, depending on how I feel. But this game is now going to be getting underway, so let's go ahead and talk about it. Whoops. There it is. There's the game. It's there, guys. And we've got a Slark first pick. So, Elder Titan, Alchemist, Naga Siren, and Visage all banned out. Vici Gaming putting a lot of value on that one. And in the meantime, while we wait for this next game, I'm going to see if I can fix the stupid Chinese stream. Work with me, not against me. Anyway, we saw the success of Slark last game. It works really, really well. That's the answer. It was a decent offlane. I mean, Vici Gaming were able to catch out the Slark a number of times with their very, very hard stun lineup, telekinesis into air. There's really not much a Slark can do about that, especially if it goes level 1 pounce. Because you do need that escape mechanism. At the same time, Dark Pact is kind of necessary. But again, he kind of just suffered early. Able to come into the mid game and late game. Pretty powerful. Though I definitely don't feel that was the reason Vici won the game. I mean, he was doing damage late game. That's great. But other than that, I didn't really feel that the Slark was that big of an impact. So Vici Gaming, apparently they feel otherwise. They're going to pick up the Slark first pick. And the Naga Siren ban out once again. Because why the hell not? Let's keep that hero out of Miracle's hands. We've seen how Titan can force game threes by picking up that Naga Siren.
5 seconds
and doing
remaining.
Their very tried and true strat.
Reserve
and
time.
It is up. Give me a minute. We'll have the Chinese stream up. Anyway, guys, if you guys have any sort of suggestions,
Radiant team pick.
Any sort of meme-related tweets you'd like to send my way, go ahead and tweet me at Dota Capitalist. You can find me over there as well as on Twitch, my personal stream, and also on Facebook. Again, I have a new Facebook. It's just facebook.com/DotaCapitalist. My old one is no longer going to be in use. I'm going to be shutting that down in a day or so.
10 seconds remaining.
And you should also get on the Twitters and let people know that we're joined Dota is covering this. We're going to be covering more and more tournaments. You're going to see us everywhere.
Radiant
we are going to be very, very busy people for the next couple of months. Toby has packed the schedule. Jam-packed. Like, me and him are going to be, like, working 12-hour days.
10 seconds.
And hardly ever seeing each other. Because we're going to be on opposite sides of the schedule.
5 seconds remaining.
Anyway, any of that sort of thing, let us know in the appropriate media.
Reserve time.
But let's get down to brass tacks for this game here. Titan is going to be able to pick up the Crystal Maiden and the Clockwork. So, very powerful offlane hero. I value the Clockwork more than I do the Slark as an offlaner, but that's just me. Vici, meanwhile, we're going to grab the Rubick. one nice thing about Slark is he is versatile enough in his role that he can fit in multiple roles. And you see on the screen right now, this is one of the stars of Vici Gaming, Super. I've been a big fan of Super for a while now.
Dire team ban.
But he's only recently come into his own. And people are beginning to recognize what a player he actually is. It helps that he's adorable. Saying, you just want to like
Radiant
rub him on the
ban.
Head or something. Storm Spirit is banned out by Titan. OD taken out by Vici. That was a big problem last game, is the OD was able to successfully win his lane. Titan played pretty passive a lot of the times. They made sure they didn't get caught out ever when they're OD in lane.
Dire team ban.
And because of that, he went into the mid game very, very strong, picked up that early four staff that made him nigh ungankable. Listen, chat, can't a guy say another guy is adorable without being called gay? That's just recognizing the adorableness of my fellow man. No biggie. Chen is going to be banned out by Vici.
Team pick.
So as I see it right now, I mean, the Crystal Main Chen combo is very, very dangerous and leads to early roaming that could shut down their mid. Meanwhile, Titan don't want to deal with a lot of those Vici signature heroes, one of them being, of course, the Storm Spirit, as we saw last game,
10 seconds
went very, very successful.
5 seconds remaining.
And also the Dragonite being able to stop, I mean, he's just a consistent hero on the meta right now, especially in the Chinese scene. Love to be able to run. I mean, he's good late game. He's a strong laner in the mid, and he's also really good mid-game push. It's optional whether or not you actually want to be able to utilize him that way. But you've seen how the Dragonite Pugna push lineup works with Vici Gaming. It's dangerous. He looks like Earthshaker. Oh, dear. Chat, the reason I gave you guys a little jig earlier.
Radiant team pick.
It's because it's my way of thanking you guys for tuning into the stream. Because normally this is like BTS's territory. And so having you guys tune into the stream like this is really important to us. It's really important to us. So that's just our way of being able to thank you. My personal way. I don't know what Toby does.
10 seconds remaining.
Nothing. He doesn't dance. He plays Dancing Dota 2 GIFs. That's just lazy. Lazy. Windranger is going to be picked up by Titan, and that should be their other support. Though I'm interested to see why exactly they chose to pick that up. I mean, it technically could be their mid as well, but I don't know. I suppose it's open. Their lineup's still open just enough.
10 seconds remaining.
And Vici Gaming are sparing no expenses. They're almost out of bonus time, so this draft may speed up a little bit now. They are thinking long and hard about this first couple of pickups. Weaver is going to be the grab by them. But we do have some decent lockdown by Titan. You've got the Frostbite, Clockwork, Hookshot, and Windranger with the Shackle Shot. All very dangerous disables versus Weaver.
10 seconds.
Two of them
remaining.
Are skill shots, so that kind of it makes it a little bit easier.
Five
but
remaining.
Weaver may have a really hard time this
Reserve
game,
time.
But it does give them a little bit more physical damage. I really worry about the fact that remaining. Both Slark and Weaver being picked up here. Yes, they can be strong in the mid game. They can be good late
Radiant
game,
but
I do feel they need a basic amount of farm to do anything, and even then, it doesn't mean they're going to be wrecking teamfights. Weaver needs a Lincoln's or a BKB or something like that to push in and just be able to split push effectively. to have that survivability. You still need another damage item on Weaver before you're good. Same goes with Slark in BKB. He's a strong laner just like Weaver is, but he falls off once we get into that 15 or 25 minute mark where we see a lot of the power of nukes. Those level 4 nukes are really what dominate that early period of the mid game. And I'm not entirely sure if Vici Gaming, like, they're going to get dominated at that point in time.
5 seconds remaining.
And Titan can easily snowball from there and keep the Weaver and the Slark from being able to obtain their basic items.
Reserve time. 5 seconds remaining.
Now with the Nyx Assassin picked
Radiant
up by Titan,
team.
They have the full range of disables. And I like a Nyx Assassin mid here. I'm still going to call for the Wind Ranger. There are a few times I actually prefer Nyx Assassin mid as instead of a support. But this is one of those
remaining.
Times. You've got two different heroes that you could shut down heavily in that time period
five
that I was talking about.
Remaining.
With the Nyx Assassin having levels.
5 seconds remaining.
I really like that idea.
Dire team pick.
Enchantress is grabbed by Vici Gaming, so they're going to have that advantage when it comes to jungle. They have a really good roaming squad as well. In fact, better than Titan right now. With the Rubick, Enchantress, Smoke, that long-range initiation from Telekinesis, it's got some pretty good range of it. And then being able to reposition that hero into Enchantress and a Centaur or a Hellbear or something like that, some sort of other disable,
They
could very easily kill the mid hero a lot.
5 seconds remaining.
So very, very dangerous. Titan are going to round off their lineup with a Morphling. Wow, I mean, Titan have been known to pick up some really interesting strats so far in the G League, but Morphling, it's going to be a long time since I've seen that hero. So they're going to have some late game. They've got really good mid game with the rest of their heroes, and now late game with the Morphling. And Morphling can always join in on some of those early team fights. Pugna was banned out by Titan, so they're going to make sure Vici Gaming doesn't get that signature heroes of theirs that pushes in. But we're going to see that countered by a Nightstalker. So Nightstalker is going to buy the Weaver and the Slark a lot of time, and you may see a lot of snowballing in the mid-game with this Nightstalker. I think that Nightstalker is just enough pressure on Titan that they'll have a chance of being able to compete them in that 15 to 25 minute mark. So I like it. Gives Weaver a lot of room, and they could potentially be fighting 4v4 a lot of the times with Weaver and Morphling both doing the split push slash farming. Titan are obviously going to be trying to push this late with the Morphling, but we've also got a Tricore set up from Vici.
10 seconds remaining.
So your choice.
Five
Ned is going to be on
remaining.
The Nyx Assassin, so we're going to see a support Nyx Assassin. Not exactly what I had hoped, but they're going to be able to run that up against the Nightstalker mid. That should be decent. Nyx Assassin definitely would have a hard time versus that.
Prepare for battle.
A nigh instant nuke coming out from the Nightstalker. It's very, very hard for you to be able to counter that with Spike Carapace. And, of course, a pause. It wouldn't be a G League game without one. Wouldn't be a LAN game without one. The all-seeing eye of Rubick. Oh, that's right. I forgot to introduce Statsman. Nahaz is in the house. Says, head-to-head, Vici is now 3-0 against Titan in Pro Dota 2. So looking good, and might as well swap over to the Chinese. Oh my goodness, they cut away from the players right as I come back. Miracle's rejoining the game now. So we're going to have a tri-lane. Or no, we're not. We're going to have a dual lane of Morphling and Crystal Main. And the Nyx Assassin. It's still a tri-lane. Sorry, I forgot Wind Ranger was mid. So I was thinking Wind Ranger and Clockwork dual lane with the Nyx Assassin mid. That's what I originally had in plan for my lanes. Titan runs something a little bit different here. They're going to run Wind Ranger mid. Nyx Assassin is probably going to be putting wards at bottom and then rotating into top. While Vici Gaming should be, their lanes seem a little bit easier. Nightstalker mid, Slark in the offlane. Once again, FY is going to be throwing down the wards. And it's a defensive tri-lane going up against the Clockwork. Clockwork's a really good hero to be able to have versus Weaver, but he has some problems with Rubick because of, obviously, getting pushed out of cogs, or thrown out of cogs, rather. Turn up the volume a little bit more. Anyway, so looking at this, the timing, Vici Gaming.
30 seconds to battle.
Early stat items up on Pan this guy. Slark is 12-1 since his rework. That is damn impressive. We've seen him. He's versatile enough to run offlane or carry, too, which is the fun thing about him. It's always fun being able to call lanes with those kind of heroes.
The battle begins.
Not going to go ahead and sit on the top room, but Fenrir's going to be able to pick it up. Illusion. Let's go ahead and talk about who's playing what before the lanes go ahead and match up. RTK is going to be on your offlane Slark. Super is going to be on your mid Night Stalker. FY is going to be your Enchantress in the jungle. Fenrir is going to be playing the support Rubick. And then, of course, you've got your carry Siler on the Weaver. Meanwhile, on Titan's side, we got KYXY and their Windranger mid, who's going to be harassing Super as much as possible. Top, you got Net, your Nyx Assassin, and Extinct on the Crystal Main, the two supports here. Miracle is going to be the Morphling carry. And then you got last person, but certainly not least, Ohio, the offlane Clockwork. We had a rather successful game last day. Anyway, Nightstalker right now just trying to pick up his early bottle. There it is. Meanwhile, Windranger has gone for a little bit more stats going up against a melee hero. She picked up a Null Talisman, so she has almost even damage with the Nightstalker right now when it comes to auto attacks, and her attack animation is very, very good for harassment and CS. So very, very even footing in that regards when it comes to CS. Slark doesn't appreciate getting harassed out by this Crystal Main. He's actually trying to fight it as much as possible. Not yet going. That's second level. Wow, I'm surprised Morphling has been picked up that often. 5-11 in 6.79. Ohio, a little bit of trouble here. He's going to get slowed down. This actually should be your first blood as Weaver comes across from behind. And Siler's going to pick up that little bit of gold. So nicely done. Meanwhile, we've got exchange back and forth between Super and KYXY. Both of them are going to heal up. And RTK is going to sit on these roads as much as possible because when the lane is pushed out, he really can do very, very little about that. Haste is going to be picked up by the Night Stalker.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Nice grab for him. KYXY. I was thinking Super might actually try and pop the haste and see if he can do a little bit of damage, but of course, we do have to remember about Windrun. Windranger could just walk away pretty easily. Smoke up Ohio. Almost sees it as he loops around. But he's going to get caught out once again. Oh, he's going to actually go into this site and try and eat this tree and come back out. There he goes. Nicely done. But Frenner's on the other side. He catches him out. He knows what's happening. Now the disables are going to be able to follow. Siler does successfully finish him off once again. So he's 2-0. What a great start for a Weaver.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
CS right now, 12-6, KYXY and Morphling are leading the board. So that slightly makes up for Ohio's really rough start at bottom. But of course, Siler is low on CS mainly because he's been chasing down this Ohio character and picking up hero kills rather than creep kills. Yeah, that was a rough game. Rough game for Vici against Speed. We casted that, of course. If you want to be able to see that match that we're talking about, go ahead and check out YouTube.com/joindota. Home to all your Dota needs. Radiant's Fenrir bottom is already tower level is under three, attack. 3.5 minutes in. He's getting the full pull experience, Enchantress getting the full jungle experience, and they both participated in two hero kills. This is how to get your supports off to a great start. Net, I'm gonna pop the illusion rune. Make sure that Super can't get it. But that's all right, Super was already bottle crowing anyway, so he doesn't actually need it. First nighttime, of course, we do have to remember a lot of Light and Night Stalkers, just because it's nighttime. Okay, KYXY, he actually leads up the Shackle Shot here. It's not gonna be enough though, it just doesn't last long enough at level one. Power Shot would have put Super low, but not low enough. And he's wind running back. He's gonna go all the way back to base, apparently. Instead of bottle crowing, he just runs back and is gonna teleport back into mid, I guess. Or I wonder if they can consider swapping with Ohio. Ohio gonna get ganked once again. Oh my goodness. Night Stalker's now rotating over. Ohio, he better be fast on the cogs. He sees them coming and boop. So this also reveals a ward is watching them somewhere in these area. Of course, it's right there, but Vici Gaming doesn't matter though because the ward is going to go down soon anyway. So even if it does get countered, it's going to lose a Dyer's minimum bottom tower is under amount attack. Of vision. They're going to go ahead and turn this into a tier one. Clockwork can do very, very little about it with Night Stalker rotating over.
Dyer's bottom tower has fallen.
Looks like he's going to go right back to mid. This first nighttime, it's not as necessary for Night Stalkers to rotate and get kills in that first nighttime. If they're off to a good start, obviously it's a good idea to utilize that good start to put pressure on the other lanes.
Radiant's
but
top tower is
sometimes you'll see Night Stalkers just farm through the first night, especially since it comes so early and the second night comes in earlier. Really, really nice. 16-10 record during December. He's now 74-61 in 6.79 after starting well under 500 due to the night sun.
Haste.
R2K is having a pretty good time top. He's level 5, soon to be level 6, and it's no surprise. Like the Rubick Mirana lane, very dangerous versus Slark. This lane, especially once you hit level 2, much easier to deal with. They can't chain stuns at all. Stun gonna go off. Dark Pack still gonna be able to save him. And here comes Super. Haste is actually popped by Crystal Maiden. Had it on earlier. So she's gonna be fine. So it's gonna be a poor rotation. KYXY and those denies. Three denies. Let's even get the last one. No, he's not getting that one. Still though, impressive. Super rotating in, seeing if he can grab KYXY with the help of the Enchantress. But we've got Ohio sitting here. He's level 5. I'm not sure why he's not attempting to pick up level 6. Apparently he feels it's a little too dangerous at this bottom lane. He really needs level 6 before he rotates out of lane, though. Morphling's getting really good farm, sitting at 47 and 7, compared to Weaver's 42 and 9. So slightly ahead in that regards, Wind Ranger is also well ahead of Super,
and it's off.
Sitting at 33 and 11 versus Night Stalker's 20 and 5. Night Stalker has been rotating out of the lane a lot, but KYXY still doesn't have phase boots, and that's supposed to be really the point where Wind Ranger is very, very harassive, and it's very easy to get CS on that hero when you have phase boots damage. ROTK is going to find Ned here. He may even be able to pick up a kill. He's going to lurk for the Dark Pack. There goes the Leash. Miracle coming over. There goes the stun. RTK, don't block him in. Miracle. Oh, no. He might have just killed Net. There goes the Spike Carapace. And he's not going to go for the waveform and extra damage because Slark is level 6. He wouldn't be able to kill him, and all Slark would do was just hide somewhere and pick up that full amount of regen. Siler's actually going to go for a bottle here and pick up the Invis Rune. This may return KYXY. Actually, wind runs. Teleports away. Nicely done. Night Stalker just not in range, especially since it is now daytime. You notice he's speeding up that second nighttime by not getting that level of darkness. And I personally really like this build. I prefer farming more on the Night Stalker through that first nighttime. Get a rotation or two, but for the most part, keep up the farm and then try and get level 11 by the second nighttime and really extend that with the level 2 darkness. That's going to be your big moment. Miracle's going to have a little bit of a hard time versus Slark as he starts getting more and more levels due to the Essence Shift, which is obviously going to steal a large amount of stats from Morphling. He starts morphing to Agility. RTK steals it. He starts morphing to Strength. He's okay with that, too. Find it interesting that Siler went ahead and picked up a bottle. This is, again, another situation. Sneaking, I had him on this morning. I think he would probably agree with me in saying that a Midas would have been a good pickup here on the Weaver. He knows he's going to farm pretty freely in this lane. Titan isn't going to rotate very much to try and stop him, and even if they do, they don't have any sort of guaranteed kill set up. So a Midas would have been a good way for Siler to get a lead on this Morphling, despite the CS difference. Very, very small difference, but still, he could be well ahead of the Morphling and farm if he had gone for a fast Midas here. Instead, he goes for Treads, Ring of Akela, which is all no surprise, good stat items, but the bottle as well is kind of curious to me.
Invisibility!
And apparently that mute button doesn't work very well.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified.
RTK, what are you doing there?
No,
he was, looping around to catch someone behind the tier 2? I got distracted because I started losing my mind and started coughing. Anyway, take a look at the gold lead right now. Vici, no surprise, sitting about a 2,000 gold lead. Very small experience gain on them so far, especially after that little bit of a Slark feed. But for the most part, Titan is okay with this static passive. Even if they're losing out on a small amount of golden experience, they're still gaining more. Enchantress is actually going to be the hero going for Midas, and I love seeing Enchantress and Midas. Not only is it a good item in general, attack speed benefits Enchantress more than most, but so does the actual Hand of Midas Transmute. Because Enchantress benefits from levels so much. Getting those extra levels in Petus can be crucial. Top, though. Thought we were going to see a little bit of action, but Super's just sitting here on Miracle right now, spamming out a couple of nukes. Oh, Weaver has a winning record with Bottle. Better record than most. Rotation over, and we're going to have a little bit of four-man while they lit the Weaver farm. Here comes the Night Stalker, activating his ultimate as nighttime comes in.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Again, hopefully he'll be level 11 by halfway through this nighttime cycle. They're just looking for that pickoff, but they can't find Miracle. Miracle went ahead and went middle, and they're going to go ahead and trade towers here if they can. So Titan should be able to trade this. FY going in from behind. We're going to see teleports. This is actually going to be Night Stalker. Maybe Super might be enough of an interruption here. In fact, it's deny range. They need to go in now. Net leading with Spike Carapace, missing both of their shots there. They're going to be in trouble. ROTK coming in for Pine. Cleans up one, cleans up two. Double kill, and they're going to go for more. Double damage on Siler's going to wipe out Extinct as well. ROTK actually snags that kill. Triple kill picked up on him, and what a way to start out this game for ROTK. 3-1-0. And he's still hunting. Lincoln's going to be picked up by Morphling, hopefully sometime Dyer's soon, as long as he doesn't continue attack. To get shut down. But this is a very poor start. 5-1. Vici Gaming leading, and now they're going to be able to not only take the top tower, but it looks like the mid duel is won. KYXY, oh, that shackle shot barely off the mark there. Now Super, he's going to look for the kill. Auto attack and another nuke would be enough, but he's going to back off. Attack.
Players here.
Titan, oh, FY. Morphling was looking for a waveform auto attack, but he just wasn't close enough in range. So Vici successfully take the top tower, put some serious damage on middle. Nightstalker actually buying the smoke here. You see another rotation by him. He's working towards that BKB. Of course, it is rather essential to work through all of those disables of Titan. You've got a lot of them. RTK going to be doing the same. Meanwhile, Siler going for the Lincolns. Smoke up, and here comes the rotation from Nightstalker and the supports. Change some mind. They're going to go bottom. They realize that that KYXY is pretty far out here, and they'd love to be able to shut him down. What they may or may not know here is that we've got three of Titans sitting behind KYXY, and they're going to run right into him. Super, it is still nighttime, so he has a big advantage in this regard. But Titan, if they all run into him, there goes Super. Nice, Cog's going to be able to lock in Super, but it's not going to be enough. They're just still taking a ton of damage. Super is too tanky, and both of them are going to fall. KYXY is now going to try and get away, but it looks like he's going to get caught out as well. 3-0. Another team fight going the way of Vici, and they have taken one hell of an early lead. 5,000 gold lead, 8-1, 15 minutes in. Titan, this is not the same game. Maybe they can make a turnaround like Vici did last time. But
Dire's bottom tower
not looking good.
Attack.
Of course, Titan do have the late game with the Morphling. They're just waiting for that Morphling to come into play. Vici Gaming know this, and they're going to put a lot of pressure. This is lineup's made for. This is why the Nightstalker. I pretty much changed from liking Titan's draft more to Vici with this Nightstalker pickup, just because it does so well being able to put pressure on Titan. It's a decent mid-game counter to Morphling. Being able to throw down that silence can be huge. And it's just enough aggression to start the snowball rolling on a Slark. Slark is a little bit dependent on his allies and how active they are in being able to be aggressive in the mid game. Him by himself, he'll often get wiped out. But if he has another ganker with him, especially a decently tanky one like that, like a Nightstalker who draws a lot of attention, it's perfect. KYXY with a decent shackle shot on Siler, but it shouldn't be enough to keep him in place. Maybe they can finally nuke him out. Oh, they actually get it. Nyx Assassin is able to pick it up. The Spike Hairbase returning damage. Ohio in a little bit of trouble here, trying to get away. The Impetus will successfully wipe him out, though. A one-for-one exchange, but definitely going the way of Titan there. Meanwhile, top, Miracle, barely waveforming away. He does have the leap away, and he will get to middle. So Slark able to turn and fight on that Morphling, force him out of lane. Oh, that's an interesting stat. About, based on 1,200 pro matches, 3,000 to 7,000 gold lead at 15 minutes. Leads with a very, very strong win rate. And of course, that's not just stomps. That also includes push lineups, right? It doesn't necessarily mean every single one of those games like, whoa, yeah, well, they've got a 5,000 gold lead 15 minutes in. Of course that. Of course they win. Because they're just stomping the enemy team. But that also includes like push lineups and the success that you get from being able to take those early towers and get that gold lead. Meta has shifted and the teams have moved along with it. Vici Gaming grouping up as four while they're going ahead and lit ROTK farm at top. Who probably joined them very, very shortly, especially given the fact he's almost about to pick up BKB. Once he has that, joins the rest of the team. We could see Lincoln's up on Vici. They could very easily fight. Now, Weaver would love to be able to pick up that second item, but the first one just gives Siler just enough survivability in these team fights to continually output that physical damage. That's all you want. The real carries in some of these early team fights are going to be Slark and Nightstalker anyway. So if Siler is able to reap the benefits of being there and still have enough survivability that it's not risky, why not? They could easily five-man if they want to, start taking down some of the other tier 2 towers they haven't gotten to yet. They just need a pickoff first. RTK is going to spy net, and there goes the smoke gank. Miracle pushing forward still because he does have the illusion to be able to fall back on. Does have Lincolns too. So once that gets to him, it is extremely tough to gank him. RTK going to run to KYXY. KYXY does have a force staff. He's just waiting. Pops a win run. And then gets back up the hill. Radiant's nice. Cog coming out from Ohio. May be able to say, oh, RTK misses out on his leap here. And Ohio may live because of it. He does have a hook shot to be able to save him necessarily, but
Dyer's middle tower.
Vici, you're going to back up now. Go ahead and take that tier one. See the gold lead increasing even more. Still, they're just trying to buy time, more time for this morphling to come into play.
Radiant's bottom tower.
And I'm interested to see what the Chinese are going to be running with the morphling as far as items after Lincoln's. Do we see a shotgun morphling? I don't personally think so. Not this game. I think we run for the hard, hard carry morphling. They're going to go ahead and smoke up, see if they can pick off Siler here. Ned's going to lead. He may have to lead with Impale. In fact, that's what he's going to do. Follow up, Shackle Shot. They need it. But still, the nukes are just going to be enough. In fact, Shackle Shot did land anyway. So nicely done. Just before the ultimate goes out, they still wipe out Siler. Good smoke rotation that's going to be able to clean up a little bit more, and they're going to go for a second one. Find FY. Ultimate from Clockwork. Going to be able to lock down FY, and he's going to get picked off. So he sees them get the kill on Siler bottom and still sticks around in his own jungle.
Invisibility.
Absolutely questionable. Now Nightstalker, or excuse me, Slark, getting chased by Titan. Again, room created for Morphling. Instantly goes to mid, though, as soon as the teleports come in. So they're beginning to buy time. They're beginning to buy time for Miracles. They've eased up a little bit of that pressure from the Nightstalker-Slark combo. But the big thing is the next nighttime, which it is coming up. It is 3 p.m. right now. 2 hours until dusk. And then it's Nightstalker's time to reign. He's got a BKB, Slark's got a BKB. Everyone's got a BKB. We got a mech up on FY. We already saw the Lincolns. Four staff is gonna be up on Fenrir eventually. BKB on Crystal Maiden, working towards that. And also working towards a mech on Windranger. And Titan just loves stalling games, man. They do it well. They do it well as they go for another pickoff on ROTK. Again, the follow-up. Looking for those extra nukes and a beautiful Shackle Shot. Gonna be able to finish him off. FY joining in the chase. Ohio's gonna trade his life for that kill. Still worth it as long as everyone else gets out. And KYXY should be fine. He's gonna pop win run.
Radiant's top tower is
get out of there,
attack.
No problem. Well, Miracle, once again, split pushing in as much as possible. Gets himself an image to be able to still aggressively push forward. Waveform, he's going to try and go for the tier 1 tower here and leap back. And he will get it.
Radiant's top tower has
fights Siler just a little bit. Forces out the ultimate, maybe waveform again, and then jump to his illusion. Meanwhile, middle, KYXY gets silenced, but the force staff will help him. BKB is activated by Super as he starts going on the Crystal Maiden. FY, got to be a little bit careful here. He's going to be beginning to fight KYXY. Pops his win run. Super picks up a kill on Nyx Assassin's Shackle. Not going to be able to latch. Ohio, still a little bit of ways from that ultimate. 10 seconds and Super should be able to get out. He's trying to dodge the hook shot. He just doesn't realize that it's still off of cooldown. And Ohio, he's got to get away. Run away, buddy. They are coming. Nope, he's good. RTK goes back to farming up middle. And Vici just control the map some more. The gold lead and experience lead looking a little static right now. But that may change as they're going to push into tier 2. Jumping in, Ohio going to get pops here. Vici Gaming going to look for tier 2 with that pickoff. But once again, Miracle, he's going to push in top and then teleport, or excuse me, jump to his image bottom. They're going to find a KYXY. KYXY waiting to use his wind runs in the last moment. Should be able to get away. Shackle will be able to latch on ROTK and buys them a little bit of harassment damage. Siler wanting to chase heroes, Dyer's but they just can't seem to lock anybody down on Titan. And they're going to start focusing on the tier 2. Net finds a ward in the ancient area. They're going to be able to counter that one as Slark goes for yet another pounce on KYXY. But again, just delaying as much as possible. Miracle Dyer's pushes in top, gets that momentum attack. Going, and then stops the momentum from the bottom lane. Start pushing
some
that.
Magic.
Action going on middle. KYXY teleporting away. Should be able to do so. Gotcha. Nicely done. Stun coming out from the Nyx Assassin on the ledge as well. Here comes Ohio. They're going to go for here. Some Miracle coming in. Tries to waveform through everybody. Ohio quickly gets wiped out. They're just trying to finish off Super. Does so successfully. Nyx Assassin once again throwing those impales over the cliff. And this will be worth it as long as Miracle lives. But Ned pauses the game. What happened? We had to have some serious technical difficulties because this is not kosher. KYXY explaining what's going on, I guess. Nyx Assassin still sitting in the back here. Still has Vendetta and Mana Boots. He still has a full combo he can throw down. FY maybe on his target list right now. What a pause. Somebody call Merlini. We got a puppy pause in action here. ROTK is in the middle of them. Miracle says we're ready to go. They're going to try and pop, but he's already got the Ghost Scepter going on. He's not taking a whole lot of damage. They don't have any other nukes to be able to finish out Miracle, and they begin to turn around. They turn around. They go right back into the Nyx Assassin. Nyx Assassin still has Vendetta if he could just get it up, but no, he gets popped. Dark Pact going off from ROTK is going to be able to save his life.
Dyer's middle tower has fallen.
And I can't believe Nyx Assassin didn't Vendetta. KYXY gets leashed. Trying to turn, looking for the Shackle Shot. Not going to throw it, though. Knows it won't be able to land, and another tier 2 falls for Vici. Getting that extra bit of gold. Yes, they are climbing. Yes, they're getting more and more of a golden experience lead. But at the same time, Miracle's about to finish up the shotgun. Ethereal Blade is going to come into play in just another 600 gold, and that is a big increase in damage. It's very, very hard to push up against some of these squishy heroes like Rubick, Enchantress. Weaver doesn't count, even though he is rather squishy, but he's got Lincolns to be able to protect him. Slark even may get picked off. That's not a whole hell of a lot of health, but with his next item, he'll actually be out of range of that nuke damage. But still, it's very, very hard to push off just because of Morphling being able to pop a hero and make it 4v5 and still be able to successfully get out. It's like Storm Spirit jumping in, but with less risk. Weaver, Siler, probably going to pick up a Desolator here pretty quick. Another 1,000 gold away from that. We could see a MKB used to be a favored item of Weaver. And it is decent versus a Windranger. You know, eventually a Butterfly is going to be up on Morphling once he starts building into some of that physical damage. But I would guess a more mid-game oriented Deso. 78% win rate. Damn. Night Stalker pops his ultimate and keeping that night extended. There goes the shotgun. We may see our first victim. ROTK, he's just over the line. 1400 is just enough to keep him alive and be able to pop his ultimate. So Miracle doesn't jump just yet, but we've got the rest of Titan. Looking to follow through. Shackle Shot, not going to be able to land. Good reactions there coming out from ROTK while the rest of his team goes ahead and pushes in bottom. Thinks about Roshan. They're really going to go for it here. They know that they're four top, but do they really have the damage? Not without a damage item on Siler. I don't think they do. They're going to start working on it. They were trying to sneak it in, but now Titan should be able to figure it out. No, the clockwork rocket doesn't all the way head to Roche. And Vici Gaming successfully pick up Roche. Without
Roshan
much fuss.
Fallen to the Radiant.
Unfortunately, Clockwork Rocket finds out just at the wrong time. Big items, big items. What do we see? Chantress starting to work towards an Orchids versus the Morphling. That's a smart choice. That's a very smart choice. Instead of the Aghanims. Slark, meanwhile, going to build into that Scotty. Net's going to be able to pick off FY. Oh, no, he doesn't get the Vendetta, but it doesn't matter. We still follow up the Shackle Shot. Very, very it's slow auto attacks come out from the heroes. And it's just enough. Ohio, meanwhile, latches a second. Super, going to BKB and teleport away. So he forces out a BKB charge at the very least off of that. The rest of Vici Gaming gonna go ahead and retreat. Slark is already halfway to his Scotty. He is looking damn fine. We are gonna see an MKB out of Weaver, which will be picked up in just another 30 gold. So we're going more late game orientation with Weaver. That's what that tells me. He's countered the butterfly ahead of time. He can pick off the Wind Ranger a little bit more successfully now. And it's flying out to him now. And going into the late game, it's not like Vici don't have some decent late game of their own. Nightstalker falls off. Slark is all right. Weaver's good late game. Enchantress is good late game. So it's not like, I mean, they've got this sort of tri-core setup versus a Morphling solo. RTK barely gets off the BKB in time. He's actually going to still get locked in by the hook shot. He's taking a lot of damage. Pops his ultimate to try and recover a little bit. He's looking for that leap away, trying to get towards his team, but it looks like he's still going to go down. Dark Pack is going to help him out, but there goes the shotgun. Dyer's wiping him off the bat, and now attack. Double damage rune gonna be picked up by Enchantress.
Dyer's structures are fortified.
Flare's here.
This is the problem. Miracle Dyer's is so good. This team is so good at being able to create space via a carry. Pushing aggressively like this. They did it with Naga Siren. They're going to do it again with Morphling. See Ohio go down. His clockwork not really feeling so well. Miracle's going to be pushing in this tier 2 and force some sort of reaction. Chance is going to go bottom. Miracle says, all right, if you want to take a fight, let's go ahead and have it. I'll see if I can shotgun you down. Doesn't quite hit the mark. He's going to go back to the base. Meanwhile, the rest. Oh, Net, maybe a little bit of trouble here. Silence does not go off in time. Still going to pursue here. They will pick up the kill. Siler gets a nice MKB prod to be able to ensure that one. Shackle shot. Going to be able to land. They may be able to burst Siler down. Looking for the shotgun. Keeps him in place. There goes the Aegis. Nicely done. And if he pops his ultimate here, he's still going to be at the same spot. So he needs to be able to Shikuchi away. Still gets out. Siler still chasing, looking for another shackle shot, unable to make it land though. Oh man, a 14,000 gold lead right now for Vici. Same goes in experience. I mean, look at that net worth right now. Morphling may be high up there, but he's not higher than the Weaver, and the rest of his team is all in the Gallows. They are the bottom of the list. KYXY just above Rubik of all heroes. But of the cores, even behind Enchantress. Weaver on a merry little chase right now. Nice little proc of damage there. RTK stopping Miracle's split push. Or is he? Miracle gonna come in from the side while Net leads with an impale, hits it. Trying to see if they can do it, and they pop him. Extra damage coming out from the Ethereal Blade is enough with the mana burn to be able to finish him off. And Vici, their smoke rotation just got stymied. All because of Slark getting picked off like that. Aghanims on Nightstalker, really. I'm not a big fan of this, unless it's by, like, the 20-minute mark. Orchid is up. They're looking for that pickoff. Miracle doesn't have that image to be able to teleport to, and there goes the Orchid into play. Miracle still being able to get a lot of strength here, and he will be able to eventually once the silence goes down. Ohio. Interesting play trying to help out Miracle. Now trapped in his own little area, and he's actually going to be able to teleport away. Net also gets out just in time before the damage comes out from FY. I mean, that was interesting. Miracle was fine. He had an image. As long as he got a strength morph off before the Orchid hit,
tower is under attack.
He was going to be good. They just don't have enough burst damage. Slark still building into that Scotty. In fact, he's going to be able to finish it off right now, as both the point booster and the Orb of Venom are going to be picked up at the secret shop. 17-9, 34 minutes in. It's a gigantic gold lead for Vici Gaming, but we've got a very farmed Morphling on the field. A harder carry than any of the ones on Vici Gaming. But that being said, the combined force of these cores may be able to take on Miracle, and the late game Miracle in a little bit of trouble here. There goes all the abilities once again. Good clockworks, and it may just be enough to save Miracle. Miracle still trying to get out, not going to be able to waveform in time, and no Ohio. Sacrificing his life in an attempt to save his allies gets picked off as well. And Vici Gaming finally get the pickoff they're looking for. They're going to turn this into pushing up into the base. They're significantly tanky, both the Slark and Super are very, very tanky now. So they can sit up front. Net hitting a nice three-man stun there. That was a great turnaround. Super actually getting a little bit low. The buyback coming out from Miracle, but it's not going to be enough. He instantly gets Orchided, and once again, that item choice from FY coming into play beautifully. As a buyback completely wasted for Miracle. Chat trivia, what player is the career wins leader on Morphling in a pro Dota 2 with an 18-10 record on that hero? Is this of all time? This must be of all time. Mm-mm. So we're going all the way back to like TI2 days. Are we? A lot of guesses. Era is definitely, I think he's definitely up there. Back when they used to run that really, that interesting carry Morphling.
Haste!
Couple other answers. Fear being thrown down. Joe, multiple times. Man, people are all over the place with this guess. Sama, one true god. Rotations coming in from Vici. They're going to see if they can grab Titan, but mass teleports are coming in.
Radiant's top tower
and they will be
attack.
Able to successfully get everyone out. And the illusion saves Ohio's life.
Homing in.
The question was, what player is the leader in career wins with Morphling? Scythe of Ice now picked up by KYXY, so they got some sort of response now.
Players
to the
here.
Weaver. Disable and the heavy nuke coming out from the Morphling. They could easily pop any hero that they want. Chat trivia, AUI's 2000 still holds the career wins on Morphling with 18. That's really, wow. Showing out to Pointer. Pointer 26 is the first person in chat. You can also tweet us the answers at Dota Capitalist and at Nahaz Dota. Vici are just controlling the game just like they did last time, except for this time they're starting out much, much earlier and controlling the game. Super with his, as you can see, Aghanims coming into play, can see everything on his screen. So Aghanim's is being useful, using the cliffs to his advantage, spying out Titan farming, so he knows what they're up to right now. He's going to keep an eye on them while the rest of Vici go ahead and do Roshan. So really smart use of Aghanim's there as Roshan's going to fall. That is not cheese just yet. Next Roshan.
Roshan has fallen to the Radiant.
I can't believe that AUI still has the win record. Even after transferring into support. Well done. Of course, Morphling has dropped off, so I guess that doesn't really matter that he's played support lately. Because even if he was playing carry, Morphling not the hero. Enchantress is about to be able to pick up the Aghanim's. Just another 800 gold. Blink Force. AC would be nice on a Night Stalker. BKB as well being picked up by Siler. So he can interrupt that Morphling combo if he gets it off in time. Orchid isn't going to threaten him one bit. Do we even have an Orchid? We don't. I was thinking of Windranger.
Players here.
Manta's going to be up soon on Miracle. Just needs a little bit of extra gold so he can break himself out of that Ethereal Bladed form and start doing immediate physical damage. And again, they're just still trying to turtle, but Vici Gaming are gaining more and more of a gold lead as they control the map. Now a 20,000 gold lead. Force Death is up on Crystal Maiden.
Night silence.
Titan. Ned is going to get caught out there. Super catches him out with the silence.
You saw me coming.
They're going to go ahead and push into the base. There it is. Nicely done. Fenrir with the Blink Dagger catch, but the Force Staff is going to be able to save. Good play by Extinct. Still, though, the Tier 3 is about to fall. Try and go for the deny. KYXWay does successfully steal that one, but Jackal Shot latching onto ROTK and Silent. This may be the opportunity. They're going to go ahead and try and pop Fenrir, but a nice Force Staff gets him away. Net with a nice double stun as well. Ohio, beautiful set of cogs. Completely interrupts the BKB pursuit by Vici Gaming. Another great Shackle Shot latching in by KYXY. There goes another leap coming in. Hookshot trying to lock in the two melees together. Super falls. The ultimate doing a large amount of damage from Extinct. Siler's going to try and pursue that one. Does pick it up with an MKB proc. Meanwhile, he's still in the middle of this. Lark is fighting for his life right now against Miracle. KYXY trying to get away. One for two so far. Now one for three is now. Slark finally does fall. All those stats stolen is for naught. Siler, he gets snaggled. What a play by KYXY, snagging the range creep and locking down Siler. And Siler is going to be trapped inside these cogs. No ultimate to be able to save him. He's still going to be able to pick up net. Uphill advantage, maybe able to know, actually. Siler does have that MKB, and KYXY barely able to get away. Both Siler and KYXY barely walk away from that team fight intact. Tier 3 did fall, but that was a couple of significant hero kills there for Titan. And you may see that gold lead and experience lead dip down, but only very slightly. Listen, guys, it's been a long day. It's been a long day. Don't give me crap with your sackled. Say sackled all I want. Maybe I meant to say sacked and shackled at the same time. So sackled them. Miracle. Aghanim's is finally up on Enchantress. KYXY is so good, though. He's so good with the Shackle. I love how Ohio still has regular boots. Like, Force Staff was too important. Ghost Scepter was too important. And he's only just out getting the gold to where if he wants to, he can buy upgraded boots. He has an issue with buyback, though. FY, he's going to get picked off. He wandered into the wrong neighborhood. Or is he? Starts to get forced half away, but still goes down. ROTK is trapped in. He's not locked in with them. They're locked in with him as he's tearing them both apart. Two heroes fall. And Titan got to get out. Extinct is probably going to go down here. MKB. No, actually, the new coming out from Super is going to be able to stop that one.
I'm sensing a...
ROTK still chasing Miracle. Nice dodge by Miracle, but he still had the waveform to be able to help him out. Vici Gaming set up well for pushing into Rax if they want to. Buybacks are up on none of these heroes. None of these heroes. Clockwork, actually, because he still had not purchased his upgraded boots. So holding on to this one. Viper, please throw up just out of nowhere some more stats that hate on Viper. Not even in a game. We're going to see a butterfly picked up on Slark very shortly here. And after that point, he is a big carry force that very, very impossible to kill. It may give him, with his BKB, just enough survivability to get through the burst damage of the Morphling. As long as he survives that with his lifesteal, his stat steal. Yep. Yeah, I'm so glad you knew what I was referencing. Well played, sir. Anyway, Super's going to be able to pick up an Assault Kuras here sometime soon. And I'm just surprised Vici Gaming, man. They are ones to control the game. I really thought they were going to try and push up into the base with only one buyback. At least force a buyback out of Clockwork or something. Nah, they're like, nah, bro. Keep farming. Get Weaver 6-stacked. Get Slark 6-stacked. All day, every day. Miracle's still behind the Weaver when it comes to net worth. KYXY still behind everyone except for Rubik in net worth as well.
Radiant's top tower.
They're going to try and upset this a little bit more by taking some tier 2s, Miracle. BKB popped by RTK. He was so afraid of getting shotgunned down. Farming, 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 farming. Vici Gaming just don't stop. Put on some country with all this farming that's going on. Vendetta steal on Rubik. He's just happy to wander around the map invisible. Night Stalker, please. Assault Kuras. I've been talking about it for a while. Just give me something to acknowledge that has changed in the game. Scythe of Ice. Items. Items! Scotty's going to be the next on the list for Miracle. Whoops.
Illusion!
Gold lead now, 25,000. At what point, Vici Gaming, do you decide enough is enough? Enough farm is enough, and you decide to actually push into the base. Please, let me know what the number is so I can just... wait for it. I can just watch the graph. And then once the graph hits a certain number, is it 30,000? Is it 37? There, is it 35,000? Is that the number we're looking for, Vici? 25 to 13. Butterfly finished up on Slark. Assault Kuras is now on Night Stalker. Is that enough now, Vici Gaming? You happy? Doesn't look like it. Slark runs away from a fight. Waiting for the next Roshan as it ticks, ticks, ticks. Another 10 seconds that it'll be up. Vici Gaming, it looks like maybe, is that finally what we're waiting for, Roshan? KYXY may get cut out here a little bit. Still has his sword staff to fall back on, so he should be fine. Telekinesis, another 4 staff saves the day. You guys say 60 minutes, but it feels like 60 minutes in my soul. Roshan gonna get aggroed on to Vici Gaming. Gonna go ahead and take this one and use the safety of Aegis and Cheese Roshan to be able to farm up some more. They're gonna use that 6 minutes as a 6-minute farm timer. God, that would be awful. It looks like they're finally ready. Miracle's going to be split pushing them, pushing in top, but Vici Gaming, they're ready. After so long, we may see Raxes go down.
Radiant's top tower has
maybe
fallen.
If Titan can defend. Siler going uphill, trying to beat on that Rax. Looks like Titan for now are just content
Dire's
to let Miracle go ahead and split push this.
Radiant's
they're down to trade Rax for Rax. Miracle is a little bit behind, but he's still about to take tier 3.
Radiant's top
Ohio is now going to commit a little bit more as hopefully it frees enough time for Miracle to pick up Rax. In fact, it is. Vici Gaming have now just made a very unfavorable trade. They picked up
Radiant's
a melee Rax in exchange for a tier 2,
fear.
Tier 3.
Why, it's magic.
Melee and range Rax all going down. And they still haven't found anything. Ohio gets four staffed off the cliff. Nicely done. Great play by Extinct. Ohio trying to clear some more room. Net getting spied out by the bugs. Actually going to get him killed. Meanwhile, Super in a little bit of trouble here.
Silence.
Turning to fight. Miss percentage may just be enough. Meanwhile, Weaver does pick up the Clockwork finally. So they grab two of the heroes on Titan, but they lost Super. Miracle is still in their base pushing in. And he's coming back. RTK gets gone on. Miracle still not choosing to jump to that illusion just yet. As the rest of Vici start pushing in. Tier 4
Dire's
starting to be threatened by Miracle.
Is under attack. Radiant's middle
he's in a little bit of trouble. KYXY may be able to get out of this one. Wind Run not up in time, and he falls now. Siler is beginning to clean up a lot of these heroes. Miracle is just going for the base. He's going for tier 4s. Vici are trying to finish the rest of Titan, but they just can't seem to finish him off. Somebody's got to go back. Siler goes to the base, activate BKB. He will be able. No! Ohio stops him. Beautiful hook shot just in time. Is it over? They don't have it. Miracle's going to clear the base, and Titan have somehow been able to successfully stop. Oh my god. Miracle jumps to the other side, and he finishes the base. Ohio, after feeding so much, hits the hook shot on the last second. Vici Gaming, you controlled the game for so long. Unbelievable. Over a 25,000 gold lead. And it just wasn't enough. It just wasn't enough. Vici Gaming just waited so long. Winner team's gonna learn not to just let Miracle do that split pushing nonsense. It messes you up. It messes you up. Well, that's going to be game 3. 1-1 tied up, and we're going to go to a game 3 where Vici Gaming and Titan are going to combat for the third place slot in the group stage, and the loser is going to go home. Guys, I'm going to go get some water, take a break, and we will be right back with game 3.